Hello, everyone, and welcome to Talent Explosion. I'm Bill Doherty, your host for our show, and really looking forward to bringing you today some wonderful performers. We're featuring Maestro's World Famous Singing Servers. We've been performing here in the Villages now for almost 10 years, and most recently at Katie Bell's, and we're looking forward to being able to get back and perform for you live soon. But in the meantime, we are going to perform for you remotely today. So I hope you enjoy that. We're going to get a chance today to hear about the lives of our singing servers, how they became interested in music and became singing servers, and what it means to them to be a performer. And we're going to get a chance to hear some of the songs that they do when we perform live. There is going to be a little bit of editing to tonight's show. Some of it is pre-recorded and sort of matched up because we wanted to be careful about the numbers of people that we had in this room tonight recording. We have to be careful because of the COVID-19 pandemic, but we're taking precautions and keeping everybody safe. I'm just thrilled to be able to have this opportunity to perform for you. This is Jared, Jared Sierra. I remember Jared auditioning for a production of Madama Butterfly, and I think he was like 13 or 14 or 15 years old. I don't know, he's a baby, but had such a good voice, and he so much wanted to be a singer and a part of the opera. Jared, tell us about how that all came about.
Yeah, absolutely. One of your students, again, Caitlin McBonagle, who's a fantastic opera singer, she came to me and said, hey, I'm doing this opera, Madame Butterfly, which I was new to the opera world. I'd only done musical theater up till then. And she came to me saying, hey, I'm doing this opera, and they just need more guys. I think you'd be perfect. So I went in, and we would do the hour commute from Ocala to Orlando at that time together, and got to know each other really well, and we made lots of good friends.
And since then, you've been so successful because you've worked for Disney and SeaWorld, and now we're going to hear Jared sing Stars from Les Miserables, one of the most popular shows in American musical Broadway theater. This is Stars from Les Miserables.
In the darkness, a fugitive running, fallen from God, fallen from grace. God be my witness, I never shall yield, till we come face to face, till we come face to face. He knows his way in the dark. Mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, the flame, the sword. Stars in your multitude, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky, you hold your course and your aim, and each in your season returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall in flames. And so it must be, and so it is written on the doorway to paradise, that those who falter and those who fall must pay the price. Lord, let me find him, that I may see him safe behind bars. I will never rest till then. This I swear, this I swear by the stars.
We're back with another one of our singing servers, David Green, who has been performing with me since longer than I can remember. I don't even want to count the years. But so, David, how long ago was it that we met and you auditioned for singing servers?
It was a little over 25 years ago.
Oh, Bill. My God, I'm only 25 years old. So how did that happen?
You were a baby.
Yeah, that was it. Okay, so you auditioned for singing servers. You came on. You worked for me in Orlando for years. Like, how many years?
Almost 12 years.
12 years in Orlando. And then David went to New York. And what did you do in New York?
Well, as an actor, I went to New York because that is the Mecca. Eventually, we all try to go there, most of us. And I did some improv comedy. I got together with an improv troupe, and I was in a couple off-Broadway productions. And then while I was in New York, I got an offer for a cruise ship gig.
Wow, nice.
And I ended up working for a Holland America line for over 4 years.
And how many countries did you visit when you were doing that cruise ship
gig? I lost count. Well over 80, I believe.
Wow.
All seven continents.
So you've made a career of singing. I remember when you came to me at Bergamo's, I really liked you. I thought this was really one of the great comedic actors that I had come across. The voice was a little bit rough around the edges, but came together. Tell us about that a little
bit. I didn't know my place when I first got to Bergamo's. I'd done a lot of community theater. I had done some professional shows, but in a non-paid, as you do as an actor starting out. And I actually came to Bergamo's singing ballads. I think my audition songs were You'll Never Walk Alone and If I Loved You, and songs that, with the lack of vocal technique I had at the time, I wasn't quite pulling off. I had pitch problems. I had support problems. They actually took me off microphone, and they said I could continue singing the group numbers, and I could work with you. And it was a terrible day, but one of the best things that came out of that.
I don't remember a lot of that, but I remember when I started working with you vocally and tried to gear you towards, you know, what you needed to do as an actor, it sort of just all fit together, and you became such a dynamic singer, and I loved it so much.
Oh, thank you. It's because of you that I've had many of the successes that I've had, so I thank you for that. And some of my best memories are of working with you and Central Florida Lyric Opera and the singing servers, both in Orlando and, of course, here in the Villages. And
you've been back here in the Villages. I mean, you came back to the Villages to be a singing server. About how long ago was that?
A little over 3 years ago.
3 years. God, how time flies. Yes, and you've done such a great job. And what people don't know about me and David is that we have been in love with the same woman all our entire lives. We have a connection because of that. So we're going to do a song right now that talks about that.
The There's a lady living somewhere. Where it is, I do not know. But I long to write and tell her that I love her so. I'm afraid I might do mayhem. Yes, I might destroy myself. If I ever find her missing from my grocer's shelf.
That's what I'm talking about.
Sara Lee, your brioche just fractures me. Give me a taste, you cherry Danish. My mother bakes well, but ya can't compare her now with Sara Lee. Ah, Sara Lee, there's no H, just Sara Lee, and that's okay by me.
Sara Lee.
When I'm nibbling her finger roll, how I love that Sara. Has there ever been a better banana cake? Cousin Milton works at the Hilton. He caters banquets, and at each affair he'll swear by
Sara Lee.
You know what I mean.
Yeah. Sara Lee.
Aren't her brownies obscene? Drop the H, say Sara.
Sara
Lee, and that's okay by me. She's got the cheesecake as white as pearl. And did I mention that chocolate swirl from the kitchens of the one I love? Wonderful Sara, beautiful.
Thank you so much for joining us for today's show, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. We had a great time, and I just want to remind you that we'll be back next week. Definitely go to the, if you haven't done it already, go to the homepage, sign up for the live feed, and please don't forget to take a moment to make a donation to the Central Florida Lyric Opera. The donations that you give will help go out to the artists and help our company continue to grow and continue to survive this pandemic. We're here to provide beautiful music for everyone. Thank you, and God bless.
This is Suddenly Seymour from the Little Shop of Horrors. Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
He'd snap.
are clean washed away.
Oh, Peter, please understand that it's still strange and frightening.
Inside me would sweet understand.